everybody. Welcome back. Today we're going to be covering the panels that we built in our last video. If you remember, we built the frame, then we put our panels inside the frame. And so it's exactly where we left off last time. So let's get started. All right, so to get started, before we cut our fabric, we want to measure our first frame at least, and then account for the long end of the frame and then the height of the frame box as well. The widths don't really matter, at least in the fabric that I got, because it's way wider than I need, so I don't really need to measure for that. But we still got 48 inches or 4 feet on the long side, and then on the height, we got 3.5 inches, just like we did before, so that's another 7 inches, because we got two sides, and then add on an inch or two, so that when we pull the fabric and stretch it around, we can have something to hold on to. So I add on another inch or two for that. And so we're looking, I usually measure mine about 59 inches before I cut the fabric. And I'm just following the lines on my burlap here to get a fairly straight cut. Doesn't have to be perfect. If you're not using burlap, you might need to measure and mark your line across the width of the fabric so you can get a fairly straight cut. So when I open this up, you can see there's several spots here where I've got creases and folds, and if you pull tight enough, you might be able to get those out when we stretch it on the frame, but I'm going to go ahead and iron it out a little bit just to kind of ensure that I don't see that when it's done and finished. It's just perfectly smooth all the way across. Alright, now so as you can see, we've got our creases and our folds pretty much ironed out, and that'll make it better when we start stapling. So we're going to lay our frame down, get it centered up, and start pulling and stapling the fabric around the edges. Now when I get this centered up, I like to, first of all, make sure I got enough around the pull on the tops and bottoms all the way around, just like that. And also, because I'm using burlap and I have this kind of grain in the fabric here, try to get it fairly squared up as well, so it's not all crooked when it's all done, so it looks fairly straight. I want to show you this also. Most of my staples, I do a staple and about a staple width, another staple, you know, leave a gap of about a staple all the way around. My staples, some of them go in real nice and some of them don't. As you can see, this one's sticking up pretty good, and I believe I'm using the 12 millimeter staples. It's just what I had around the house. You might want to try a 10 or maybe even an 8. I'm not a staple expert, but apparently if they're sticking up like this, shorter ones will help, which makes sense. But some of them go in fine, some of them don't. So I usually just take a little hammer and just tap them down a little bit. And then because they are so close, then it's not really a big deal. It holds just fine. As I mentioned earlier, this side is way longer. And so all I did is fold it over and guesstimate a cut here. Doesn't have to be all that accurate. There we go. That was probably the ugliest cut in the world there. But I started to drift away. One thing to keep in mind is when you get down to the corners, you don't want to have too much excess, because when you go to wrap the corners, it'll make it more difficult. So you want to have the least amount as possible, but still comfortably wrap around at the top here. And then when we did the first side, I didn't pull it tight because there's nothing to pull against. But on this side, I start in the middle, and I pull it fairly tight, and then we just start stapling, always pulling tight as we go. That way we get it as taut against the frame and the panel as possible. So one thing I like to do, typically as I'm going along, is just to double check, make sure things are looking like they're setting up okay. And we got some of these vertical lines, and that's okay. But all the horizontal ones are pretty much pulled out. And these vertical ones will tighten up once we do the short ends here. So looks like we're good to go. And of course, as we're doing this side here, I already did the other side. We want to pull these tight so we can get all those wrinkles out. And again, I lift it up again to see, make sure we got those wrinkles that we had last time. Those are all gone right there. We still got a few along the edge of the frame, and that's fine. That'll pull out. Those should pretty much pull out when we do our corners. So one thing that's a design flaw or design feature, depending on how you look at it, I have these brackets here and a staple stop here, which I actually want to kind of stop before I get all the way to the corner anyways, because that'll allow me to tuck this. And so I pull the long side around, tuck it underneath the short side there, and then pull it like that. And then you have a straight corner against there. That's, of course, obviously very loose. The problem is when you go to staple it, I have to staple it in the bottom and on the inside. I can't staple it here on top because I'm on metal. But because I'm using burlap, if I had these on the front side, that would show through because my burlap's pretty thin. So I just work around it. It's not a big deal. All right, every corner I've found so far is a little different. Just depends on how much fabric you have here or whatever. This one is being a little finicky, so I'm going to cheat it a little bit. And I'm going to go ahead and put a couple staples to get this side really tight. Like that. And now, of course, tucking this under and pulling it up. And if you get a little slack, sometimes you just need to tuck a little more. That's all it takes, so just a little more tuck underneath. There we go, that's looking pretty good. And again, I have to do mine on the outside instead of on top. But they end up hiding pretty well. And I got a pretty nice corner here. With other fabrics, it'd probably lay a little flatter. Burlap kind of just gets a little rounded, but that's more or less how it's done. All right, for hanging this, I'm just using some regular eye bolts or eye screws. They're number 208. I don't think it really matters, just short. So once we put them in here, they don't stick past this. So I don't get too technical. I basically just find the corner down here. I have my drill bit at a certain length, random, and then I just drill it in the middle of that drill bit length, somewhere in there. And that's my pilot hole. And then eye bolt, we'll just stick it in there. I usually stick it through the fabric. So to hang this, we're just using this wire here. And all I do is just stick it through this eye bolt, that, stick it through the eye bolt over here, simple enough. Get it in the ballpark. What we're aiming for is for this part right here to be just below the edge of the frame. That's where I want it. And then I just use my pliers here to cut that excess off. And then I come over to the other side and do basically the same thing, except this time I'm going to make sure that it doesn't go above that frame. It's just below the top of that frame at its tightest. We're all done. Double check it. And usually I get near the center frame, pull it up, just put a little peek in it. That way when we put on the hook, it's got a nice little guide to set in. All right, last thing we do before we hang these up is we're going to put some spacers to make the back side of our panel right here, the acoustic panel, 2 inches off from the wall. So what I did, I got just some of these little felt self-adhesive things like you put on the bottom of a chair to protect the floor, and you stack 3 of them, and we're gonna put it right here, and that will make it exactly 2 inches from it. Now you can just stick this on here if you want, and it'll probably work, but it's on that fabric. So what I do, I just found these little teeny tiny nails I had laying around, and then we just tap that in there, and then make sure the head of the nail is actually countersunk a little bit so it's not touching the wall. And there we go. Just do that on both sides. Alright, so now that we're done building our panel, we've covered it, we've got the spacers on there and the hanger, all that stuff, we're ready to put it on the wall. So I've got mine measured out here, my placement right where I want it, and I'll show a close-up of this, but I have these hooks. They're picture frame hooks, and they just go in the wall. No screws, no tools, no nothing. They're really nice. And I already have it installed, so you just poke it in the wall, grab your hanger, and to make it easier, I let it hang down. And of course, like I said earlier, we put this little notch there in the middle of the wire, and just hang it up there on the wall. All right, so a few final thoughts while I wrap this up. I hope you guys found this useful, first of all, and it helps you. Of course, you can change any of the design you want. If you want to do it differently, go for it. But hopefully you found a couple maybe useful tidbits in this. Also, you see I used the burlap fabric. It actually ended up being a little thinner than what I thought it was gonna be. And so the cotton panel comes through. It's kind of a dark blue-gray. So you can kind of see that. Actually, I ended up kind of liking it. I'm going to paint this room again anyways, so I'll probably use some of that color to play off of with the other stuff. Plus, I have some other ideas I'm going to do with it. Also, as far as the 2-inch gap between the back of the panel and the wall, I'm not an acoustic expert by any means, but from what I've read, that helps it absorb a little bit lower frequency, so it extends the frequency range a little bit that it absorbs. That's just what I've read on the internet. Everything's true on the internet. I know there's tons of places where people are arguing back and forth about those kinds of things, but that's what I did. If you want to put it flat against the wall or whatever, go for it. Whatever works for you. This is just what I did. So again, if you have any questions, let me know. Leave them in the comments below. Again, I'll try to answer those. If you haven't seen the frame build video, I'll put a link to that as well. And again, hope you enjoyed it. Hope it helped you out, and see you next time. Thanks.